I'm basically going through all the casters in Skorne, so...
Seems fun. You gotta play them before they get invalidated by errata.
Yeah, you know. They're going to nerf Skorne again, so...
When every apple in the barrel's rotten, it doesn't really matter what one you pick.
So, this one I just made before I came. It has Despolier, Agonizer, Gladiator, Razorworm in the battle group. And then it has a full unit of Karax, full unit of Ferox, Tyrant Rhadeim, Feralgeist, two Catapults, and a min unit of Beasthandlers. Yeah.
So what's the game plan of this list? Just like kill everything with Catapults, and then the rest of your list just runs away?
well, Karax don't. They're immune to blast damage.
That seems right. So you can just shoot your characters in the back then and kill things?
Yeah, or I can just tie stuff up and then shoot them.
Seems right.
Yeah. I don't really know what the plan is with this list.
I'm thinking I might know what the problem is with Skorne armies. Made this list, I had zero plan.
I had a plan when I made it, and I forget that plan.
What could possibly go wrong? What could
possibly go wrong? Well, basically, the spoiler's there for the free upkeep, so Hexeris keeps more fury on himself.
What was he, like, 18 points?
Yeah.
So you're taking an 18-point beast for free upkeeps? That's your primary reason?
Well...
Is that a Skorne problem?
That's a Skorne problem. Optimus Marketh can't do it, you know? Unless you get souls, and when he's getting souls, your stuff's dying, and you probably don't need upkeeps as much anymore.
That's fair.
Catapults are, you know, try to get support models in the back when you pop feet. And, Karax are just a good, cheap jamming unit. Which Death March makes them more accurate. Razorworm's just a good arc node because he has the. What's that thing that doubles your leash or extended leash?
Yeah, whatever it's called.
It's extended control range.
It's either that or it's like long leash.
Long leash, yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
There's kind of. Actually, both of those exist in Hordes.
Yeah.
But extended control is only in Warmachine.
So, that's what he's for.
He's got advanced deploy and, like, dig in or some bullshit.
The Razorworm, yeah.
Yeah. My shooting is screwed.
Ah! Didn't break. And then, yeah, character, Ferox are just, they're quick, maneuverable.
I'm just sad I can't shoot you.
Manamana.
The age-old Worm Hordes problem. Not being able to deploy your models because your cards are there.
Yep.
That should be like War Machine problem. Infantry Machine.
That's why I think War Room came out, so you actually deploy your army.
So, question from chat, Darrell. Are you going to have good rolls tonight?
I don't know.
Did you bring your good dice or your shitty dice?
I brought these ones.
Whoop.
Those are the shitty ones, aren't they?
Over to Darrell.
These are the loaded ones I bought.
Oh, nice, nice. They're only fives and sixes on
them? Yeah, only fives and sixes.
Yeah, that should help you.
I think so. I'll still roll snake guys at least once, but I don't know how that works.
Somehow.
All right. So my list is Calandra with Mulg, Mauler, Axer, Bouncer, and a Runebearer. And then to help her out, I've got Lanyssa and a Chronicler. And then a max unit of champions with Skaldi Bonehammer and a Sorceror. And this list is more of a pairing for my Doomshaper 2 list. This one is built to take on the stuff that it can't, so lots of high def. And lots of shooting it has a problem with. So Calandra with Starcross hopefully can deal with that. Really, to be honest, I haven't found a list I'm not comfortable dropping Doomy 2 in. So this is just the...
It's practice.
I gotta have two lists.
Yeah.
So, yeah, this is practice because I'm gonna have to play it at least once because most places that we go are DNC one, so.
Yeah, I think that's, I've seen a bunch of tournaments actually popping up that are two list optional.
Yeah.
It's kind of nice. Meaning that if you just want to play one list all day, you can do that. But, yep. you don't have the second list to batter around.
Which I'm becoming more fine with.
I'm certainly okay with that. I mean, if someone wants to just play one list all day, I'm fine with it. As long as they don't have that second list that they're using to skew matchups.
Well, some people.
Well, how can you do that without like reading their mind?
Well, some. Well, just because if you drop a list, like if you take like, if you like say you wanted to play Irish 2 all day long, but then you have like a Karcha of Mad Dog list that you had with it, that you had.
Oh, okay, I got gotcha.
Then
I gotcha.
People have to drop their armor cracking, or else they're gonna get screwed by your Mad Dog list, and then you end up just dropping Irish 2 into like what could be a good matchup kind of thing. Like that's the theory behind that.
I'm picking up what you're putting down.
Yeah, but I don't know if that's actually a big deal or not. But at least if someone just wants to play one list all day and they don't care, then they can just do that with one list and they don't have this outside factor kind of thing. I don't know if it really matters that much, honestly. But
already deployed wrong. I'm going to change this.
Wrong.
Here's a hint. If you're not going to get first place, it doesn't matter. You're going to get DQ'd, whether you play one list or not.
Hey, I did awesome at the tournament. I only had one gimme game. And I lost to Tim Banky, which I don't really feel that bad about.
You should.
Why?
Because if you beat him, you would have been the best.
No. This is not Pokemon.
You
would have been the best.
You could have taken his badge.
Why can't it be Pokemon? I don't
know. You kind of are catching your models when you go by them at the store.
It's true.
You're going to have to catch them all.
Yeah, you got to catch them all. And then play them. And then watching your models get nerfed, as you know and love them.
So that means Skorne, all they have is slow pokes.
We're going to take away every single speed buff. And then we're going to take sidestep away.
All right, Kassem, over to you.
My AD.
Hey, we got to shake hands on your clock.
No. Do you have any AD?
Top tip from Darrell, shake hands on your opponent's clock.
Do you have AD? No?
No.
Sucker. All right, good luck. On my clock.
On your clock. Burn your opponent's clock, people. It's the best way.
It's the best strategy of the winning. So, I got stuff and things. Whatever, let's just start with Hexeris.
Please don't do that on me.
Too late.
I will.
It's too late. It started. He is going to put.
Salt. Hey, Darrell, what do you think about Durst into Sloan?
What's Sloan's feed again?
It's everything gets to shoot twice on their activation.
Oh, yeah, he's fine. As long as you're battle group heavy with shield jacks and you're running your infantry is something like TFG.
Yeah.
You're fine.
Basically, what I was saying is that you basically move up and you stay like nice and far away. Next turn, like turn to your feet.
Yeah. If you go first,
and
run.
As long as you can jam his gun line, the turn after you feet, you're gold.
Yeah. If you go first, run. If you go second, just walk. Because he'll be at extreme ranges.
Yeah.
And with proper positioning, you won't take much shooting.
Yeah.
So go ahead and take it, and then.
Definitely, like I'm thinking. Next turn, I'm thinking Templar, then Shield Guard, right?
Templars have shield guard,
thinking,
so
like,
you can protect.
Two Templars with Durst, and he's unkillable. Like, completely unkillable.
Yeah, and I think the Inditer will see play with him when it comes out.
The Indictor?
Inditer. We called it the Indictor, but it's the Inditer.
Is it actually? Okay.
Yeah. Because it's got the 5-inch no spell bubble, and it's a shield jack with, it's got 1-inch melee. So I think with Durst, it shows good play.
Because it'll be armor 21.
It'll be armor. Yeah, it's 21 base.
And then 20.
25 on his feet turn.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
And then, you can move it up.
So this guy's asking, what do you think of you taking DeBray, Anastasia DeBray, with Durst to try your first turn?
I like it.
Yeah.
I like it.
Is play worth it? I definitely thought...
Finding room for it will be a problem.
That with some of my mercs lists as well, like Ostrom in particular. Ostrom Gunlines really want to go first. I put her in those lists just to go first.
Yeah, and Durst wants to go first so he can run that first turn.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
finding the points might be difficult. Durst doesn't really care if he has a vassal or not. Like,
So you drop a vassal.
You drop two vassals and an off the taker.
Okay.
Because she's 6 points, isn't she?
No, I think she's four.
Four? Yeah. So you'd have to drop a vassal on a rack. I usually find Durst is fine with two racks.
Yeah, so while they're talking, Hexeris put Death March on the Karax, Soul Slave on the Razorworm. They charged wherever your conversion is back there. Lanyssa?
She's not a conversion, it's just Lanyssa.
Oh, she's only three.
Three? According to perfect,
the
that's one
according
for one.
To chat, yeah.
Then Gladiator rushed himself and slammed at that one
something,
champion.
Yep. Something I usually have in my Durst list that I get good work out of
yeah.
is Nissia.
Yeah, she's a badass.
Because you can run her up in behind the TFG, she jumps out, kills some stuff, and jumps back behind the TFG.
For feet turn, she can just snug up to a jack.
Yeah, she hugs a jack and she's invincible, so.
Yeah. Razor Worm's gonna run somewhere.
But I don't run Lights with Durst.
Where is Karina?
Sorry, I was running Lights with Durst. But they were just for flags.
Well, I mean, Relaw's in the chat is trying to tech some stuff with some anti-sloan tech because he's getting screwed by her in his meta. So he's a protector player. He was saying, where is it here?
What's the sloan list just offhand?
I don't remember. So Relaw's, tell us what's in the sloan list that you have trouble with.
Just ballpark. It doesn't have to be exact.
He's saying battle group of two Templars, Scourge, Fire Salvation, and a Vigilant for Durst.
Drop Scourge.
Yeah. Don't
drop Fire Salvation.
Really?
What's Fire Salvation doing? You have one unit, so you're going to get one advance out of him. He does not benefit really from his feet, so you're paying 16 points for a jack when you can save yourself a point and take a Templar and get the same job done. Fire Salvation works with Durst if you're running Combine Arms. It is my opinion that Durst isn't the Combine Arms army.
He also had double exemplars in his list, so he had
okay,
changes.
That makes more sense. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That makes more sense. I would definitely switch out the exemplars for TFG. TFG have been better with him, in my opinion.
I definitely like, so TFG is good for specifically anti-Sloan, because
yes.
they'll run farther across the table to jam his guns, and
yeah.
they really Sloan really hates that.
So
if you're trying to tech for anti-Sloan, TFG is actually probably going to be better for you than double exemplar. Exemplars, though, will murder the fuck out of hunters.
Yes.
And Signar Jax in general.
Another option, Durst is one of the few lists I would run Errant's in.
Errant's, okay.
Do not take the UA. There's no point.
Okay.
The UA just gives them, like, immunity to spells for one turn. Fuck
yeah, yeah, no, it's not worth it.
So just take Errant's.
Can you give them something else? Reposition or something? Go for
it? No.
Weird.
That's the solo.
And
two units of Errants are fine. They will benefit from
take Rupert if you have problems with rough terrain.
Yeah.
Those guys are speed 5.
Rupert with TFG.
Four.
Rupert and TFG are best buddies.
Yes. They are.
You could also take
don't fall into the book and Rupert trap.
You can also take Pyrus and he gives them relentless charge.
Pyrus is amazing. Take Pyrus.
Yeah, Pyrus is awesome. Take him with TFG and then they charge rough terrain if you need to and they just have a relentless charge
and Pyrus just does work. Pyrus will wreck a light on his own.
Yeah, he's awesome
and
Pyrus
he's immune to retaliation
beast.
As long as he's in base with the TFG right,
just don't forget to put him base to base with
yes
the TFG.
God put him base to base with the TFG. Do not forget, write it on your hand. So speed 5 they are. All right, so we're going to start with the what do we want to start with? Calandra. No, we'll start with the Runebearer.
Discount Games Inc. is your friend, Relaz. Especially if you're in the U.S., it's super, super fast shipping and super cheap. It's more expensive for us because it has to go across the border because we're in Canada land.
Canada,
yeah.
All right, so Harmonious Exaltation on Calandra.
But in the U.S., like, DGI is just really, really good.
The Axer is going to rile for one and run. What's the threat range on the
Karax are speed 5? Are these 5 or 6, Kassem?
Karax are 5.
Speed 5 with reach. With 2 inch
reach.
I should say.
They have Pathfinder or access to Pathfinder?
Yep.
5.
So one of the Sloan lists was 5 hunters, max commandos, and defender.
Sorry, give me a second. My brain's not there. Okay. He's going to have to wait till my turn's done. I'm not smart enough to be able to do both.
That's fair.
I have children. I can no longer multitask. So the bouncer's going to put Earth's Blessing on Calandra. No, he's not, because that's illegal. He's going to put Earth's Blessing on himself and run. Charge your objective.
What's Earth's Blessing mean?
No moving me around.
Knockdown stationary and other stuff.
Yeah, all the shenanigans, basically. Anti-shenanigans. Alright, Calandra's gonna go. She is going to do things. Did you know that?
Things and stuff.
Both.
But stuff.
Maybe. I don't know. I don't know her that long. she's gonna spend two using Harmonious Exaltation for Starcrossed.
Yeah, so the first list that's five Hunters and Max Trencher Commandos and Defender is actually pretty vulnerable to being jammed because Hunters, like, they can't afford to take free strikes from
five into the stone and then advance.
They'll just blow up. The other list with the Murder Ponies is probably a bit harder. It's got magic weapons in it as well, so it's going to potentially be more likely to harm your jacks and stuff.
Mulk's going to go. He's going to do...
And Eris is always a problem. And the gunmage solos will make it so that it's harder for you to actually hide your caster from Sloan's assassination, which is a problem as well.
He's going to spend two to do Arcane Suppression.
Oh, Terran does the same thing as well. Yeah, the Shadow Fire. Except Terran only has like a 15-inch threat on it, whereas Captain Adapts have like a stupid range.
And charge of the spoiler.
Mark won't try to murder spawner. Can you even see the spawner?
Yeah, Reinhold's always
lots
given
of fog.
With,
yeah,
Sloan,
I think so.
No doubt.
I might be cheating already.
Cheater.
I'm a dirty cheater.
Cheating like a mofo.
Oh, you have the better legs.
Okay, I'll charge the Agonizer then.
Gonna charge my Agonizer.
Charge the Agonizer to avoid cheating.
Overrated.
Okay. So that's Mulg. Alright, there's Mulg. And he's got Arcane Suppression in play.
Your face is an Arcane Suppression.
Suppressed your mom's face with my ball set.
Oh, snap.
The Mauler's going to advance five. The Stone is going to do Spirit Chaser and Protective Aura. And run. Or press forward, as it were. Let's go here. Speed 10, so lots of room.
It's like you've been doing some painting.
A little bit. Working on it. I get about.
It's like Kassem's glued together his Ferox.
I get half an hour a night.
Sorry. Still no riders. Someday.
We'll okay, there. And lastly.
I magnetized a tail on all my bugs.
That's all you found. Give him a hand, everybody. Give him a hand.
Look, check how cool this is, guys. It's a sentinel, and then it can turn into a tail.
The Chronicler's going to advance.
Nice.
Six. To here. And put. Tail of Mist on the champions.
What's that?
Plus two concealment. And if they're knocked down, you can't shoot at them or doing that shit. So, yeah, fuck your hat. Mm-hmm. Okay, then we're going to do some Pathfinder?
Yep.
Yeah? Okay. This is the first time I've used champions this edition. Actually, any edition.
That's all right.
They're going to do a charge order or a press forward order.
Press forward. Are they Pathfinder?
I'm in charge, yeah.
Ah. That's good.
That's, yes. So going eight on the charge. So charging the gun there.
I was
going to
say.
Go.
Put them right behind that water. It's kind of an idea.
It's the only spot for them, and with Relentless Charge, I'm okay.
Yep.
What is that?
That's one that makes them an Arcanaut.
Oh, it's just suddenly out there.
I forgot it back there.
Base to base.
It's on video.
Charging here. Base to base. Charging there. Base to base. And just run. Go to here. Base to base. Skaldi going running to here. Mm-hmm. Base to base with two of them.
They get the plus two armor on their base to base.
Plus two defense.
Plus two defense. It's weird. Yeah. Plus two defense against melee.
While in melee.
What's that? Defense 12?
Well, plus two defense while in melee.
Huh.
But the Tail of Mist gives them plus two defense all the time. Because they have concealment. Yep. Over to you.
Well.
So they're basically 16 all the time.
14 all the time.
Yeah, sorry. 14 all
the time. 16? Oh,
yeah, I know, right?
My erection would be so large as we'd be knocking the camera over.
Just grab that spoiler off.
Who am I kidding? It might be nudging my measurement.
Spoiler up keeps one for free. Xerxes will spend one to keep the other spell.
Lake Athabasca. What else did I get? Duplicates. So sorry, what was the chat question?
What's their defense?
I was just asking about some stolen pairings.
12 base.
So
they go up to 14 in melee.
So basically, the two different stolen lists he was playing against, one was five hunters, trencher commandos, and a defender. The other list was min ponies, min trenchers, two hunters, two defenders, Iris, and then two of the GMCAs. So they're both really assassination lists.
What's their armor?
Are you sold on Durst?
What's their armor?
Their base armor is 16.
And then plus if they're within the stone.
If they're within range of the stone, which is currently 8.
So, nope. No. So for Terrain, and Starcrossed is up.
Of course.
Bum, 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 bum.
16 inches.
So Hex is not with that.
What do you think? Champs with Borka 1 and Arcane Ward on them. That's the plus defense.
Champs with Borka 1 are awesome.
Yeah, that seems good to me as well.
Something I've been debating on for Borka 1 is Axer Spam.
Axer Spam with Borka 1?
Yes, because he has Mosh Pit. So you go in, Thresher, everything gets knocked down.
Oh, that's pretty good.
And then you can send in some of your shittier sort of spammy troops.
Okay.
Like Fenblades would be good because they have the cleave and whatnot.
Oh, with the UA?
With the UA, yeah. So you can move in and start hitting all the knockdown guys, killing them.
Potentially, yeah.
So I think Axer Spam could be a thing with him. But yeah, champs are awesome with Borka. Just in general.
Cool.
I'm waiting for a theme force, like a Northkin or a...
It's coming.
Or Family Reunion again. Because Family Reunion was just fun.
See if the fog goes up.
Yeah, fog...
I'm hoping they bring back the some of those iconic are gonna tiers.
Yeah, like the there's a Crusaders of Sol was awesome.
And even some some weird ones like that Zirkova Honey Wolves where she could take Vanguards.
Yeah.
And I think like some of those weird lists where like you have these counter players that bought a whole bunch of Vanguards for that list and now they can't play them anymore.
Oh, for people watching, I'm a bad player. it turns out it helps if you activate all your models on your turn.
You forgot Lanyssa?
I did. No. She's only fucking bright yellow and white. And I see a blue, so
you can run her.
You don't forget Lanyssa.
Yeah.
You can go ahead and run her.
You don't mind?
No.
Yeah, I just want to move her to here.
Can she run that far? What?
More than enough.
North can seem pretty
Thanks,
cool.
Thanks, Kassem.
North can seem pretty cool. Like the Fire Eaters are really
You'll have Fire Eaters, Borka will be in there.
Yep.
The Shaman, which I'm thinking two Shaman might not actually be bad. You guys talked about it on the cast.
I forget what we said now.
You could do a mini Cloud Wall.
Yeah. It seemed not.
It's actually not bad tech when you think the two of them cost 6 points or 8 points.
Yeah, and they're good.
That's the cost of a troll solo.
They'll do some work as well.
Right. You guys. Something I wanted to say for the chat too. You guys talked about how the Fenblade Kithkar is okay.
Yeah.
I think he's shit.
he's
4 points. For one more point, you get a Fellcaller who does 100 times better.
Yeah, I guess. But you could do both.
Okay, but the Kithkar just does plus one to hit for just the Fenblades.
Yeah.
The Fellcaller does plus two to hit for everyone.
Well, yeah, but only one unit at a time.
That's all the Kithkar does.
Will walk up.
No, it's all Fenblades.
Okay, so if you're running two units of Fenblades.
Yeah.
And he will say...
I'm saying you can do both, though, and you get a three-mat swing, which could be a big deal in some games.
If you want to run
and
both.
He's just an okay combat solo for 4 points, that's all.
Yeah, I don't like him.
He's not amazing or anything, but I don't think we made him out to be amazing.
You guys like... I think he's trash.
I don't know. Sometimes we're too positive. And sometimes people are mad.
What did I do with my tokens?
Circle did not like that we didn't like Una.
Yeah, that seems like it was pretty harsh.
I thought she was really bad, but
yeah.
I still do.
Well, in the chat where people were talking about the podcast, the Troll Podcast, which has gotten pretty good reviews.
Okay.
People were talking about how they couldn't see how you guys like stuff. I'm like, remember, they don't have faction-colored glasses on.
Yeah, that's fair.
Right?
It's a fair point.
In terms of Mark's reviews, he's got he's got swan glasses on.
Oh, totally, yeah.
So
it's hard to listen to sometimes.
He's like, Jarl is so good. I'm like, shut up, Mark. He's not good.
Yeah, he's,
really he's great for infantry. How many units of infantry do you see in Trolls? One, maybe two.
Arcandy from the chat is saying that Skaldi makes champs Northkin as well, which is pretty sweet.
So yes,
that'll be sweet when the Borkets here, whenever that happens.
Yeah. I'm sorry, to get back to, I don't know who it was who was asking about Durst.
Gonna go.
Versus Sloan. Are you sold, is Durst who you're going to play into Sloan? Or are you sold, are you open to other casters?
He was playing, so basically he played a tournament this weekend, Relaz.
He's gonna cast. He played a tournament this weekend. Here onto him.
He took Krios 1,
I think. What are
you doing, sir? Krios 1 and 72.
Okay. Three dice.
Yep. I'm out of your control.
Who's the point of origin? Who's the point of origin?
Target War Beast. So point of origin would be through here. But he's casting.
Okay.
What does Starkos say?
Yeah, what's Starkos say?
It's an attacker damage roll. Or sorry, it's an attack roll.
But does this person making the roll have
to be what does Starkos say?
Well, when spellcast control range enemy models gain additional nine attack rolls. Yeah. So
he's
not the one attacking.
It's still actually making the attack.
Yeah,
you're good.
So I need a 7 hit, I guess.
He was playing Krios 1 and 72.
7 hits.
And he got stomped by Sloan twice.
So I'm going to influence him too.
It's like Krios 1 and 72 is not that apparent.
Make an attack. He'll attack the guy beside him.
I'm not a fan of Krios 1.
No. Well, that's you, though.
So they're
mad. You don't have old man stats.
He's got super old man stats.
Yeah, he does.
Not 7.
Him?
Yeah.
Sorry. Yes, Matt 7.
So it will hit.
He's attacking him?
He's attacking him.
He's attacking him.
Yeah.
Matt 7, defense 14?
Yep. I rolled 7.
Okay. He's under Starcross, though. He counts as your model right now?
Does he? It doesn't say it makes him an enemy model.
I'm just wondering what it does.
What are you talking about?
I'm casting influence.
Okay.
So, take control of a target enemy non-warcaster, non-warlock, warrior model. The model immediately makes one basic attack.
Enemy models?
Yeah.
Enemy models gain additional die. I'm just wondering for the duration of the spell.
Well, he controls it, it's an enemy model.
So, roll another die. Take away the highest.
That'll miss.
That'll miss. To be or not to be? Well, I'll cast it again. Why not? Same guy.
Okay. Defense 14.
8 hits. Yeah. He will do the same thing.
Yeah. Nope.
Holy, that's horrible.
Ooh, so nice there. Who is he trying to influence? The champs?
Yeah, champs. He's trying to get the champs to hit each other.
That seems pretty good. Champs are good at killing champs.
You are not wrong.
he's going to walk.
Sorry, what was his
couple
name?
Inches there.
The Chaka? It was Relaz.
Relaz, are you sold on that pairing, or are you just trying shit out?
No, he's not sold on it. It's just that he only had the models for Krios 1, pretty much. He wants to try Durst, which I know you would recommend.
I love Durst.
Yeah.
Into Sloan.
Yeah.
I would actually play Resnick 2.
Yeah, I also mentioned Resnick 2 as well, just because the whole no non-magic shooting.
Resnick 2 is amazing in any gun line except Rhett.
Well, I mean, what about have you run into Murder Ponies with him yet?
To who?
Murder Ponies. Because they can put a whole bunch of brutal shots into him. That seems dangerous.
Yes, I was okay, though, because my Durst list runs Flamebringers.
Mm-hmm. Durst or Resnick 2?
Resnick 2 runs Flamebringers.
Okay.
And he was okay because the Flamebringers just zip right in. Because my Resnick 2 is Flamebringers Idrians.
Huh.
and both of those can get into the murder ponies fast.
Okay, that's fair. So as long as you bring a counter for the murder ponies, then Resident 2 will
actually Ferox really are going to do.
And it's not just for forward. The murder ponies, because both of those units do well against lights. The Adrians actually do well against heavies as well.
Well, Adrians are amazing in general. Like that's like it's just like they're like nobody plays Adrians. Let's make them batshit crazy and insane good.
Impact.
And they didn't even do that. They took away assault and battery and said, "Okay, they're fine."
And made them sheep.
Not sheep really. They took like a point off.
What changed? Why are they so good now?
Because they fucking Rochambeau'd Errants into the dirt finally.
Miss. These are impact attacks.
Okay.
This guy will charge the one beside him.
Okay.
Wait. Going crossed.
Yeah.
So basically, Kassem doesn't hit a single attack roll yet because of Starcraft.
Yes.
This is amazing.
I am def 14 as well, which doesn't help.
Yeah, that's fair. Which is why champs with Calandra is so awesome to me.
That misses. And second impact. Misses.
Oh, jeez.
These are just as impact.
Are they sixes or sevens?
Sixes.
They're sixes,
yeah.
So you need eights.
Yeah, it's rough. Now his charge attacks are probably still going to hit and kill you, so because they're boosted from like, targeting.
Yes, this is true. So it's four dice.
So it basically cancels out Starcross. So yeah. We'll see. Attack. But it's still going to be mat sevens hitting defense 14s.
Yeah. Only none of them are in stone, so that's my deployment issue. I made the wrong choice there.
Oh, that's too bad.
But I might be all right.
Nice. Yeah, this just in, armor 18 champs, way better than armor 16 champs.
Turns out.
Yeah.
He is going
And also, you could have fixed it by running him over here instead, right? You shouldn't be over there, right?
No.
That was a mistake.
Yep.
Also not activating Lanyssa was a mistake, as far as that goes.
Oh, he let me run around.
Oh, okay, that's fine.
He's going to go out.
He's not going to be able to charge.
So this guy is just gonna charge him to here. Impact.
Nope.
Ouch! Wow, your dice are extra bad today.
I don't even know if they could see those on the chat.
Like, even without Starcross, you would have been missing this shit anyway because you're rolling so bad.
I know.
But
what's
his name again? Roche or whatever.
Rolos?
Yeah,
Rolos.
Rylas. I would say try
Rylas.
Alrighty, let's
try Resnik 2, Sevi 2 for your pairing. I think you might like it.
The problem is Resnik 2 is expensive,
drop
and he's a college student.
I still hit.
Yeah, Durst. Durst is cheap. Buy Durst.
Brutal.
Spend a little less on weed and save up.
Yep.
Pow 14.
Okay, pow 14. I'm 16 dice off 2.
8 points of damage.
Okay, tough check. Nope.
Okay. This guy was on him. Make sure he faces properly. Yep. So take that. A 7. I hit a 13, so I probably
misses. 14 misses.
Him on him.
Yep.
Wow, I'm rolling horribly. And then him.
He says, unfortunately, no weed, just books and housing.
Oh, okay.
That's normal student stuff.
You read books?
7.
Wow, university's changed since I've been there. No, no, that's cool. I can. That's fair. That's fair.
Is there 1-inch melee?
Yes.
So I'm going to repo him.
To like it is your intent to reposition into Mulg's control threat range?
Oh, shit.
He's always been in Mulg's threat range.
I'm just curious if that's what you want to do.
Into his melee range?
Yeah.
What's his melee range do?
2. His melee range means he can hit you.
So?
Okay.
Well, you don't have a defensive truck like that.
Yeah, I do.
What? Really?
No. Shut up. Cool? With Doomshaper, I do, not with Calandra.
Yeah.
Hey.
It's
you can't go there. My token's there.
It's retaliatory.
I placed it there specifically.
Those guys have parry?
No.
No.
Rhadeim does, though, right?
Probably. No. I don't see it on his card anyway.
Son of a cock. I think the stream died.
That's not cool.
Eh, whatever, they can stay like that. Me.
So he wants a pairing with Sevi 2, basically.
Durst
is
away.
Durst
really
is good. Durst is good.
Lance.
Durst and like 5 heavies.
Jump, trigger, damage. Whatever.
Or Durst and 4 heavies and a light.
He's going to I'm pretty sure he can.
Yeah, feed's gone.
Yeah.
Gone?
Just reboot it. Son of a bitch.
That is a son of a bitch.
Son of a bitch. So, Rhadeim, you're still recording, right?
Wait, yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Right. Rhadeim is going to charge that guy.
Yep.
You gotta glue him to the basement.
Well, he has like a lot of parts to assemble.
You can assemble him after he's on the base.
Yeah, you know, so if I want to prime him and stuff first.
I don't think he's in close enough. There you go.
Yeah. And let us make my charge attack. He is a mat 8.
Don't know why this keeps happening.
Oh, come on. Come on.
That's a miss. Starcross for the win.
I am like rolling horribly, horribly, horribly. Well.
That's amazing.
He is going to repo.
Repo your mom.
Repo. Right there. Excellent.
Yeah, I don't know what I was doing with stone, other than just being a terrible player.
This guy can just walk to here. Son of a
bitch. Yep.
And, you know, why not? He can dig out.
I don't have any shooting cast.
So?
Okay.
He can do it. Why not? So, I just want to make sure I measured this correctly. What's Mulg's threat without rush?
7.
7, so he goes to 9 with rush. Gets that guy within 10, that guy within 10. So it just makes Calandra out. So Despolier is going to walk up to here. Mm-hmm. He's going to put Arcane Suppression up.
He's going to pay double for it.
I don't care.
Because my arcane suppression is
it. Fine. I'll pay for it. I need it fury anyway.
Oh, he's paying for it.
Oh, because that's from last turn. And, where did I put this?
Yeah.
Yeah, boy.
Looks like it's back.
The Gladiator can run. Just within 10 inches of Mulg. Feralgeist can run to here. 1, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I need to get 1 fury away. These Beasthandlers will walk. Whip the fury off to Despolier. Math is right. 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes. And then the catapult crew will walk. And it's gonna go bombs away at this guy. I think. I have an 18 inch range. So I will do. So direction black. 1 inch to the 4. So,
yeah.
So 4 incher, or is it a 5 incher? 4 incher.
Yeah. So it's blast damage on the two of them. Small base, 4 inch. 1, 2, 3.
Just get him?
No.
one, two, three, four.
Well, so we'll start with the stone guy.
Yep.
Pow 8. 9 is a 17.
Okay.
Oh, wait, I could do a tough check first.
He kills.
Ah, fuck you.
And the guy beside him. 7's a. On an 8's 15.
That's exactly armor.
Okay, and then Calandra. Nothing. And I don't wonder anything near a guy. What's his armor?
A billion.
Well,
21.
In his back, no shield.
Oh, 19.
So it's dice off. 11, and I rolled
no
11.
No shield. Yeah, 19.
No damage. And I think that was the 4. Okay.
Yep.
This catapult is also going to work. And he will shoot. Same general location, why not? He will shoot at Calandra. Just actually.
I'm within 1 inch of a model with a larger base.
Yeah, whatever, he'll just shoot at the guy behind, or the same guy. So 18 inches is there. Direction back.
1 inch to the two. It's like on Calandra's head.
So catch, I'm assuming that's 4 guys.
I think so.
Yes.
Yep. Those 4.
So I'll start with the same guy that hit before. Nope. That's horrible.
Sure was.
Those are all below average.
I will take it though.
5 and under on all those rolls.
Where is is that Sentinel in your army or no?
No, I was just gluing him.
Just playing with it.
Is there, are we back up or what?
Yeah, we are.
Okay, cool.
Okay, back up.
Oh my god, you're on half an hour. Alright.
Jeez.
Arcane Suppression goes.
That was not worth half your clock that turn.
Yeah. Earth's Blessing is gone.
Wasn't it?
Stone
wasn't
gone.
You killed one champ.
Alright. During the maintenance phase, models within 4 inches of Effigy of Valor stand up. That would be my stone.
Yeah, bitch.
Yeah. Okay.
This seems like a really good objective for trolls.
You think, yeah.
Or anyone who takes lots of stuff.
Alright. So I'm back up to full with Calandra. Alright, I'm going to start with the Runebearer. He's going to advance here and do Harmonious Exaltation on Calandra. Mm-hmm. Then, what do I want to do with Calandra? Am I within the kill box? I'm good. My control range. You are in it. Want to do Calandra yet? Oh, roll for the smoke. Smoke goes away. The smoke is gone. So you are within 9 of Mulg. Or
I should have been. Like
you're within 10 of Mulg. You're like 9 in a bit, but you're within 10. What's your control range?
14.
Or sorry, it's Arcane Suppression I'm worried about here.
10 inches.
Yeah. So the Mauler is outside of it currently? Yeah.
Just all 3 of those beasts are.
Yeah. All right, so let's do some shit.
You planning on killing all things this turn?
I hope so. The stone's going to go first. And he's going to do Stone Strength and Protective Aura. Do I need Stone Strength? Better safe than sorry. Stone Strength. And run. Yep. Before I do that, I cannot fit through there. So if I go...
That's what she said.
Sorry. 5... Nine, 10, put them there. You know what? We won't do the stone yet.
Retcon.
I haven't actually done anything.
Judge!
John, my opponent's a cheating bastard.
Filthy cheater.
Okay, Mauler's gonna back up a hair. Here. And put the Rage Animus on Mulg. Mm-hmm. Wait a second, that might be stupid. And you're 10 inches away there. So I need to kill those guys. Alright, so I will start with Bouncer. Just gonna go here. Mm-hmm. Yep. Right there. And for two, put Earth's Blessing on himself.
Does it cost two or it costs one?
It costs one. Mm-hmm. But you're making it cost double because you're there. Mm-hmm. That's my attack. You're still
hat. No, Skorne hat first.
Face head. Alright, then Calandra is going to spend. No, I don't want to do Calandra yet. Stone is going to go. There. Protective aura and stone strength. Mm-hmm. The rest of the guys need to move around. Alright, that's them. Mm-hmm. Now Calandra. Two for Starcross with Harmonious Exaltation. I'm outside of 10 as well. I'm outside the kill box, I'm outside of 10. So two for Starcross, leaving me on 6. Don't have line of sight to anything. I might have line of sight to the Despolier. Let's see. I'm outside of 10 of the Despolier. I'm going to spend 1, 2, 3. I'm going to put 4 into the stone. So it's full. Mm-hmm. Camping 2 on all feet. That's that. Mm-hmm. So. Sorry, he's supposed to be there. Because I moved him and then said, no, I'm not going to activate him. So actually, let's just say I fucked it up. That's where he is. Well, I did. I fucked it up, so that's where he stays. All right, the Axer is going to charge. Okay. Like this. Base to base. Mm-hmm. So, in. Him. Mm-hmm. Have a little more distance. Actually, I have to go over there. All right, there we go. In with all three. You agree?
Yep.
All right. So rolling to hit. You have set defense, I assume.
Yep.
Okay. This guy is not my charge target, so no set defense.
This is correct.
All right. I am at 6.
That's 14.
14. I need 8. I'll just hit on him.
Oh wait. 12, because he's not the charge target. 6 to hit.
6 to hit. I'm not gonna do that. I am POW 15.
Minus 2 from him.
Okay, so 13.
Anything but snakes.
You did. Snakes. My charge target, I need an 8. You roll 1s and 2s on my feet. Oh, miss. Here. Hit.
Snarks.
Okay. Okay. He's okay there?
Mr. Axer.
Next. The champions are going to go. They have 1-inch melee. Aura is 11, so everybody's in the aura. You're fine right where you are. Alright, so Chronicler's going to go to here. Do Tale of Mists again.
Conceal it?
Yeah, concealment, and if they're knocked down, they can't be shot at. Alright, so this guy.
They don't need to move at all?
No.
Is Skaldi within 1 inch of that dude?
He's in base to base.
No, I mean the...
Oh, he's got 2 inch.
Oh, okay, never mind that.
Yeah. This guy on here.
Mm-hmm. Matt's 13.
Matt's 13. No. Matt 7. 6 to hit. We roll 1s and 2s.
Oh, that's so broken.
5 misses. Still missed. Second initial.
Dodge you.
From what?
They just have dodge with the redeem and everything. Dodge allows you to ignore free strikes.
Okay, second initial here. We roll 1s and 2s. That'll hit.
That's better.
Armor 17.
Now 12 weapon master.
Pistol 5.
Roll 1s and 2s.
That's better.
Let me check to make sure I'm not cheating. I think it's on hit and damage rolls, but.
Oh, yeah, better check that. I think it's both, but.
Better make attack sure. Or damage roll?
Yep. Brutal.
Okay, I have overtake. And I'll just use it to do that. Mm-hmm.
So they don't have parry, so on their activation they don't get it, but they do have dodge, which is like...
Yeah, Rhadeim gives it Mulder in his command.
He gives...
Dodge to the Ferox.
Dodge, yeah. That's pretty sweet.
I'm gonna check something. Okay. He's gonna attack him.
Does he have the range?
Should. Yep. Boxcars will hit.
I knew.
The same size template.
So close.
It's over your base right now.
So close. What do you think, Nick?
That's totally it.
I'm going to switch it to your clock in a second. Top 12 weapon master.
It's a 5.
Ha!
He has 1 box. 4
damage.
1 left.
Alright. And next attack. Hits. I think you got this.
Wow. You wasted those.
I'm not gonna. I'll turn like this. Base to base. He's stuck there. Mm-hmm. Heal attack. five will miss.
Let me just do this one. Proper pitching.
So you're in melee with the bouncer? Is that the intent?
I don't care.
I'm asking if it's the intent.
Why? What's the bouncer do if I'm in melee with him?
Nothing. I'm just wondering if that's your intent.
Yeah.
Well, is he within 2?
Yeah.
I don't care if he's
within 2. So what's your defense in that melee?
Charge lane. That's what he's trying to do. So.
Yeah. All right. And he's going to zap you with a magic attack.
He has magic?
Yeah, it does.
17.
Yeah.
He's in melee though, right?
That's nice. Magic ability 6. I need 11.
Feet.
Not gonna deal with feet. Yeah. So 1-2.
Yeah.
Or roll on his defense.
Is it just the bouncer?
That'll hit.
Yeah. I just dodged backwards a bit.
cool, I get to slam you now. Alright. Alright, cool. So that's them. Oh, I didn't roll damage, sir. It's fine.
Bounces like armor 21 or something stupid.
19.
Okay.
Yeah,
still really good. Fine.
It's like he's aiming that wand at the at the Ferox, and then one of the champions knocks his hand and aims at the bouncer in the back. It's like, no!
Over here?
Rhaenyssa.
Why would I go to there? I forget. I go there. Within two, and that is way less than nine.
Nine with rushing. Yeah.
So when this soul hunter's mark him.
Oh, that works too.
That hunter's mark.
Oh. As long as she hits.
Hunter's mark is plus two.
Yeah.
Swing.
What's your defense?
Ten.
Ten.
Oh, the Ferox is 13.
8 will hit.
It will.
She's defense 7, so hunter's marked.
So free charges and plus 2 movement on those charges against that thing. Seems pretty good. So you proxied it out that you can get Mulg to nestle in there and then have...
And then I have reach on the Gladiator.
Yeah, I thought that seemed good. For the stream.
Yes.
And free strike from that guy, probably.
This is my fucking care face.
You don't care?
Relaz is asking, can you tell him what your Resnik 2 list is that you play in Sloan?
Yeah.
So, lucky hit. With hit, pow, this is a 12.
Or 20.
So dice off. 8 is 10 to the 6.
Okay. You 10 to the 6 at armor 20?
Mm-hmm. I rolled 6, 6, 4, 2.
Oh, because you cheated, okay.
Where is it here? I wish it was a 5.
It's called a 5. It
there you go. This one instead of 2, this one is the 2 units of Adrian's option.
Okay.
But it works.
So Daryl's handing me his Resnik 2 list. It is Resnik.
All right, so.
Carifont, Crusader, Hand of Judgment, Scourge of Heresy.
Charge for free because of Hunter's Mark.
Mechanics.
My initial is going to be his fist.
Min Choir.
I finished.
And then 2
units of the Agonizer. Sorry, minus 2.
And Roven
and
Co.
Plus 1 from the stone.
So
11.
Two units of Idrian's. I'll be pushing it. But you could run Idrian's and then Flamebringers as well. That would also probably
so,
be
okay. Big Mini Fist is pal 15.
So he's a mat 8 or a 7?
Mat 7.
So you need a 6 to hit.
9 hits.
Have you ever thought about...
I've since switched it, though, instead of 2 Adrians to...
They soft 2.
Back to the Flamebringers.
Okay.
Pardon me?
They soft 2.
Well, I have 2.
Armor 17? Oh, wait, 17. What's your pow?
With your minus 2,
the
pow
list
15.
That I just said, Darrell switched it
so
to
off
me.
Two?
Instead of double Adrians, it's Adrians plus...
8 damage. I will smack you.
Because Flamebringers are broken.
And heal... 1. Okay. So my second initial will be on. I want to kill the guy weird right here in the Razorworm.
Yeah, that's weird. Most people are playing for both of them.
19.
I find the Hierophant is more useful for the most of the game, especially with the severe lack of infantry going on.
Fair enough.
Sorry.
10-19.
10-19. Mm-hmm. How many boxes?
30.
Okay, and on him.
He is 13-15. 21 boxes.
Okay, I'll attack the Gladiator first.
Mm-hmm.
So, 7, I need anything but to hit. Hit. Alright, and then damage, I am pow and strength 18 base, down to 16 from your Agonizer, up to 17 from the stone.
Dice off 2.
So, dice off 2. Is 8 to the 3. Okay. By an attack. 4 will still hit.
Once
do
again,
I want to slam
that battle group that Darrell takes with Resnik 2 was Crusader, Hand of Judgment, Scourge of Heresy.
If I slam you, you can still charge me back.
Scourge seems like a no-brainer for the Arcane Vortex.
What do you think, chat? Should I slam that Gladiator or just keep pounding on it?
Do you want my advice?
I think I should kill it. So I'll take the hit. Dice off two. It's 5 to 6. Blind attack. Hit.
Oh, Relos said slam it. Too late.
I've got two more attacks. Dice off two. It's 6 to 2. Blind attack.
I think the right answer is killing it personally.
Yeah. I'm getting greedy. I'm trying to get the Razor Rim as well. Four will still hit. Mm-hmm. Dice off two. I'll re-roll that because that's bullshit. Six to three. And by last attack. Now if I slam it, I will. Eight will hit. Mm-hmm. And then dice off two.
If you didn't have Hand of Judgment, Darrell, what would you put in that list?
It's 6 to 1.
6 to 1.
And I will snack it.
Snack it.
Normally I would take the Avatar.
Avatar, really?
Yeah.
Non-battle group.
It makes it very good. It still benefits from Boundless Charge.
Yep.
Okay. It's fantastic into matchups like the Karchev Mad Dog spam.
Sure.
Or Griffin spam, because you can put the Avatar way on the flank. And it keeps those few lights out of the battle.
Yeah. Oh, wait.
Those lights don't hit hard enough to kill them.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like can it. The Feralgeist jump in there before it gets snacked?
No, because it's an RFP.
When does the Feralgeist jumping in take place? Let's see here.
Command rate is destroy, but not remove from place.
Disabled box destroyed.
Yeah, snacking removes that box, okay. So it's not destroyed.
It literally says not removed from play. When it's destroyed, not removed from play.
Yeah.
Alrighty, so let's start with my vengeance.
Vengeance.
So my feed is done.
Did you get enough out of it?
I did some order of activation fuck-ups.
Did you get much out of it when you're hitting the Gladiator? I feel like...
Yes, I was rolling eights. Okay. So I was getting a couple extra points of damage. Mm-hmm. I only killed it by, like, two boxes.
Okay.
Because of the Agonizer.
Oh, yeah, that guy's a dick.
Yeah. I did an order of activation problem. That's okay. I meant to put Rush on Mulg with the Axer.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't. It's what that boils down to.
And so you basically,
or sorry with that.
So basically, Calandra. You needed Lanyssa to do it, or else he wouldn't have been able to do any of that stuff. Then, like, you needed Lanyssa to hit.
Yes.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I would just sat there otherwise, and it would have been a wasted feat. But better.
You would have been better off than trying to Hunter's Mark the Razorworm instead.
Yeah.
Well,
I didn't have line of sight to it because the Ferox is in the way, and there's a large base.
Oh.
See, so I'm at seven. So he'll go first.
3 days. Yep. That's 7, def 12.
9 hits.
Okay.
Pow 10, what's his armor?
19.
2 points to 2.
2 to the 2.
Next guy. 6 and a 7 is a 13, so he hits.
Okay.
They're not 7s.
They have Death March on them. No damage.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That's pretty sweet.
The other guy. I should have had Death March on the Ferox, apparently.
Probably should have. Although the dice doesn't matter.
That guy on the Mulg, he's in his back arc. So I hit with 10.
It doesn't matter. Mulg is defense 10. Armor 21.
21. So, no damage. Alright, that's them. He's not going to bother swinging. So I could take over Mulg with the Feralgeist. Let's see
3 inches like that. That guy's out of command right now from this guy.
Well, he does not get to activate.
Well, he can't.
Well, he doesn't get to attack or anything.
So, I don't want to get greedy. Oh, yeah. And I'll read my Furious.
It's probably a good idea. Yeah. Upkeep it.
Despolier keeps that for free. Hexeris will upkeep that. So I have 6 on me now.
All of that with this time, Kassem.
Well, I didn't do anything. I didn't do anything yet. I was just hypothetically. Death March happens before reading, so. So I could. Let's see, Hexeris needs to activate first. No questions about that. But
with Resi 2, what do you think of double Templar Scourge?
Doable. Yeah.
Yeah, I like that. Like Templars just seem amazing.
What are your infantry choices?
I think he's planning on taking them with Adrians and Flamebringers.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah.
I like that.
That seems good. I mean I definitely like Templars, especially if this is gonna be your anti-range tech list. A couple shield guards is always going to go well for you.
Yep. Kel Balok is nice.
Yeah, Kel Balok is amazing.
Kel Balok is fantastic on his feed turn as well. Because his feed is not friendly faction. So you pop 2 models where guys are grouped up and there's a 4-inch AoE.
Oh, that's really sweet. That's some good tech. Kel Balok for auto-hitting AoE shit.
Yeah.
Sounds awesome.
Kel Balok and Alton Ashley, if you take them both, it's 2 shots.
Yeah.
That's 4 4-inch AoEs from his feet. They're fantastic.
Basically, everyone who can take Kel Balok should be taking Kel Balok. He's amazing. Yes,
that is a true story.
He's so good. He's in almost all of my mercenary lists.
Okay, so what are you doing now?
So Feralgeist ran to there.
Yep.
Beast Handlers will go, methinks.
Here, let's not confuse the issue. Hold those guys back for a second. Because the smoke disappeared on my turn.
Oh, hey, smoke.
And the axe is actually facing that way for anyone watching.
So they go, and they are going to pop up some enrages. Enrage, enrage.
How do you like that horrible 2 skull, by the way?
Nice.
The fire on the sword is sweet.
I love it.
So good.
I don't know if I'm going to be able to get him, like, play him. Because I'm super sold on the list pairing I have right now.
Yeah.
Like, he'll need some sweet tech.
We'll see, I guess, but I mean, maybe he'll be amazing. You never know, right?
I love the old Horgo model.
I have a feeling he's going to have some gimmick with pyres that you're going to be like, fuck this shit about.
It's going to be stupid.
Yeah, it's probably going to be dumb.
Despolier is going to walk up to
Una's
here.
Thing with Griffins seems pretty awesome. What, like, flanking Griffins? Like,
yeah.
Holy shit, that seems awesome.
He is going to swing.
That would be almost enough to make you play Griffins.
Snake eyes.
Tail first.
No snake eyes. Hey, hit.
Woohoo! I'm effective POW 19 with Dark Shroud and Enrage.
Off 2.
Is 5 to the 5. Claw attack. Look, I hit with a 7. And the claws are an effective POW 17, so dice off 4.
Off 4.
Is 3 to the 4.
Rolled 7.
Yep.
3 to the 4.
Next claw. 4 hits.
Yep.
So dice off 4, we said, is 6 to the 3. Buy a tail.
Not snake eyes, so.
19, dice off 2. Is 4 to the 5. By a tail. Yeah, snake eyes misses.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
By a tail. Oh, a 4 and a crit, brutal damage.
Oh no. Was fucking 4 hits.
They soft you.
He's dead.
Oh yeah, that's terrible.
it is 10 to the 4.
Kills him.
Nom 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 nom.
But then, I mean, you didn't really expect him to survive, did you?
No.
9, Calandra is 10 away, so I'm gonna read your fury, bitch.
Okay.
Nom, 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 nom. I'm up to 7. And Feralgeist is going to jump in. But I can't activate him the turn he goes in, right?
No, so I'm just going to kill him.
Are you?
Yeah.
There's like a whole unit of champions right there. Turns out they can kill
currently him. There is.
Yeah, you're not going to kill all the champions.
Miracles can happen.
This is true, but it's not Christmas, and it's not
34 Street. If I go into here, I have to watch it for him, which is not a big deal. He's armor 19, you said?
Correct.
Okay, so 5. Let's do this first. Agonizer is going to walk up. How many Fury does Calandra have?
Just one, two.
Two. Agonizer, well.
Two, because he's amazing!
Walk up to here. He's going to go minus 2 strength bubble. Na-na-na-na.
Just for you guys in the chat, we have non-crunchy snacks today.
No crunching.
Hexeris is going to activate and pop his feet, I think. Yeah, pop my feet, activate.
Which feet do again? Oh, if you kill shit, it becomes black.
Yeah. It turns into an undead model, can advance 3 inches and make an attack.
Oh my god!
Goes wrong, that could be bad for me, but it won't go wrong.
Your face went wrong.
He is going to charge your Axer.
But my Axer, why are you putting your caster up there?
Reasons.
Bad ones? Are you tired of this game?
No. So 7, you're 13?
12,
so I need 5. I do have the luxury of boosting. So I'll boost.
Okay.
Oh, look, I still hit. I have a 7 there.
Yep.
And I'm a pow 14.
Armor 19. All 5.
So that is 9 to the 6. Golgotha. Golgotha.
Kassem's a cheater for rolling average.
It's true.
Clearly his dice are loaded.
I'll beat him back. Why not?
Beat the back.
You can beat back a larger base?
Yeah.
I thought it was a push. Guess it doesn't matter. Whatever. I don't know the rules, so it's fine.
But like, base size doesn't start from pushing stuff.
I'm thinking...
With slams, it's half distance, but that's not sick.
Okay, so that is good. He's not going to advance... He is going to cast influence from him onto that guy again. Because why not?
3 dice.
Miss. 14. I'll cast another one. That hits. 5, 5, 5. So he is going to swing at that champion again.
Okay. It's in the rear arc, but I'm def 14.
Goes down to 12. I still mess with snake eyes. So
all that math was fitting with you.
Snake eyes.
Sneaky sneak.
Snarky snark. How many boxes do you have left?
11.
11.
Wood stills and gone.
Lots of stuff.
That's what the Axer looks like.
Not too bad.
I'm going to spend 2 for a spin of groove.
It's obviously now unplayable that it's armor 17 base, right?
No, they just took one armor away from it, which is
is
reasonable.
Armor 18
is reasonable.
Light was completely ridiculous.
When I saw it, I was a little salty, but I'm like, okay.
It was ridiculous.
Yeah, for a guy with a giant axe, you're armor 18 base, aren't you? Yeah, you're totally armor 18.
Yeah,
I understand that one.
Yeah.
Does it affect living and undead models?
Does what?
Your feet?
My feet's not on.
No, I mean your
Star-crossed.
Yes, everything.
It's everything.
Enemy models.
All the things.
All the things.
If you had some weird-ass attack with your objective, it would affect that.
He's just going to walk up to here.
Okay.
I'm going to do my melee attack, mat 6.
That's 14.
Boost a hit.
Okay.
A 6 misses.
Yeah, it does.
Damn.
They have retaliatory strike? Because I just rolled it. I think Skaldi actually does, to be honest.
No, it's the hero that has it.
He used to have it.
Used to. I'm gonna, why not, buy and boost another attack on
buy and boost.
That will hit.
That looks like a hit.
That'll hit. That's enough dice.
I'm a power 14.
I'm 18. Off 4. Stone.
Off 4. Oh, hey, 5 points. That's
oh. Tough.
He toughs. Oh, you're too far from the objective. That's too bad.
Yeah.
When I box an enemy model, I can drag him below and make a full advance.
You didn't box him because he on disable, he made his tough check.
Oh, on disable, it's the tough. Okay. Yeah. So he's done.
But drag below is pretty cool. If you don't, you know, do it to a tough model.
How many boxes do you say have left? Like 6?
11.
11.
Yeah, a bunch.
11. So.
6 plus 5.
6 plus 5. these guys will shield wall advance.
Do you have enough movement for that? Because that's rough terrain.
Yeah, it's 2.5.
Okay.
Sure is. It's been a dick.
Hey, dick.
Yeah, you could have got there. It's fine.
I'm going to shoot you with my bomber.
Boomer.
That I don't even own.
Do you own a bomber?
No.
Weird. What's wrong? We got a lot of flack for not liking him enough on the cast.
I like him. He's just expensive.
I think they're fine. Like, I think they're, like, a decent piece, but just, like...
They're fantastic in the right list.
My problem with them is that their gun can only ever be range 12. It can't get any higher than that, because it only gets to 12 by sniping itself, and you can't snipe something twice.
But he's speed 5.
Yeah,
so it's 17 is threat, but... And you're not rolling the hit for that.
I definitely undervalued the rate of fire too. Like being able to buy a second shot.
The rate of fire
super is strong.
Big.
I'm going to do
but
a 2-man CMA
really
on that.
Expensive.
He's armor 19, go up to 12.
But it's also power 16 gun, which is pretty
I'll
awesome.
Just do a 5-man, why not? Nothing but snakes to hit on. That's not snakes.
Not snakes.
5. They go up to mat 12. So 5 takes me up to a power 15.
Four. Sometimes you gotta roll 4. Wow. That was shit.
There. That guy can pounce. Pounce.
I pounced your mom.
Pounce. Oh yeah, and these two guys will do a 2-man on a skull.
Okay.
8 will hit.
Times 14.
I'm 12. 18. That's 6. That's 3 points. Dank. Rhadeim. This is going to be a lackluster feat. Well, let's go with my catapult crew. And I will sling a shot at that guy.
Sure. 3 dice.
Woohoo! Miss with an 8.
That was a him?
Yep.
Okay.
Where'd my deviation dice go?
There's 2 different color dice right in front of you.
There.
So
3 inches to
the
one.
He's like over here.
4 inches away.
3 inches to the one. It's here.
Let's get that guy for sure.
You're clipping the elder?
The Elder, pow 8.
How many points is a vassal?
3.
Nothing.
Vassal mechanic.
What else do you take instead of that? I was going to say Lanyssa, but Protector can't take that shit.
Thought he wanted to take
same guy.
Anastasia? That was the. I think that was a different list. I think that might have been the Durst list.
Still not bad.
Still, I mean,
Resnick likes them though, because he always
wants
their to camp
defense.
Their defense
so,
is 12.
I mean, vassals are good. With Resnick, yeah. He was saying he was going to take one to remove Disruption from Scourge. Seems okay.
How often does Disruption come up?
I don't think he comes with that often. I mean, other than Iris, but then again, he's running with Templars, just Shield Guard anyway.
If he's running with Templars or Flamebringers, Iris is not a problem.
Yeah.
Direction 5, like 6 inches.
6 inches?
Yeah. So it'd be kind of like this.
No, because you're shooting from there.
Oh, from here.
So 6 goes that way.
No, direction 5.
Oh, direction 5.
6 inches, yeah.
You son of a bitch.
There, 4 inch.
No one.
Nothing. So we have the Ferox and Rhadeim. Well, I feel like Rhadeim needs to really do something. So if Rhadeim walks up to here, he could like pounce. Let's go with these Ferox.
Yep. He doesn't get to go.
He can make a full advance.
Yeah, but he's not going to attack or anything.
Like that.
Yep.
This one is going to pounce. So I'll start with my pounce attack.
Oh, he's a character?
Yep. Pounce attack, so a 10 will still hit you.
Yeah.
And it is a pow 12.
Dice off 7.
So question from chat is, what do we think the new ret character jack is going to be?
Then normal attack, 10 hits.
That's a question for you, man.
Yeah, I know, it's a question for me. So, yeah, like, so he was saying that Doug Hamilton said it's going to be revealed at Warmachine Weekend. That's actually not true. Doug is going to be working on it on his computer at Warmachine Weekend. And so he's saying that if you come talk to him at Warmachine Weekend, he's going to show you. But they're pretty strict. Like, if you take pictures of it, he'll be really pissed off. You're not supposed to put it online because it's still a work in progress. But he's going to show it off to people that are there. And so sometimes people come on and they'll describe it, but he doesn't let them take pictures of it. So it's not actually being officially revealed. He's just going to be working on it.
Yeah. Some pictures might be put out, but sometimes, whatever you change, like, it will be, like, whatever you see could be completely different.
It could be changed, yeah. It's totally a work in progress, yeah. And, I mean, they get pretty pissed off if you take a picture of it, because, like, he's showing people because he's excited about it, and he wants to, like, show it off to people.
And we're excited about it.
He doesn't want people putting it on the internet.
The team's gonna walk here.
So, yeah, don't be a dick and take pictures of Doug's models when he's working on them.
I'll do my lance on him.
Okay. Is that technically front or what?
Oops.
Is your intent to be in back?
Let's see if it matters. So it doesn't matter either way. I rolled a 15.
What was your
total
intent?
Well, to be in your back, but I hit either way.
Yeah, I'm in back.
So you go down to your base 17 or base 18.
Why are you?
Armor pierce.
Okay. So 17 goes down to a 9.
Yeah.
Yep.
Plus 2 is 11.
Then, so dice plus 1.
That should be
8 points.
Kills it.
Nom, nom, nom. He has 1 fury on him. It's my fury now.
All good for you.
And then he can repo back to here.
Okay.
Who do I think it'll be for? Oh, fuck, I have no idea. The new rat character, Jack. I'm hoping it's going to be for Kalissa.
Okay.
She deserves a character, Jack.
Kassem gets a control point.
Oh,
yeah.
Kassem gets a control point.
Yeah, with Mulg.
With Mulg.
So Earth's Blessing goes. Starcross goes. I'm going to pull that Fury. Tail of Mist goes. I'm on 4, so I'll cut up the full. Your feet's only on your turn, right? It's a 1 turn, not a 1 round?
Pretty sure. Last for 1 turn, yep.
Oh, as Ivan said, so someone in the chat says that it's going to be for the starter box caster, Elena. That'd be cool.
Likely.
I'd be down for that.
That's what they did for Protectorate. It was for Malekith.
Is it? Okay, so maybe all the new starter box casters are getting character jacks then. That'd be kind of cool. I'd be fine with that. I mean, I love Elena. She is super strong, especially because there's so much ranged out there, and she just, like, dick punches range lists. Like, just don't drop Carousel into her. You'll get fucked. It's bad. Helena is super strong in Burn Eyes.
Well, okay, if we're going according to the fluff, and Z-Car would get a character gladiator named Azur.
Maybe you will.
You're Azur.
Oh shit, man. That's harsh.
Gonna complain about
that's
it?
Harsh.
Alright, so you're engaging Lanyssa?
Yep, they have reach.
Kind of makes you a dick.
She's fine. She can still spell stuff.
Harmoniously exalt the lady, as you do. Oh, now you're in shield wall.
Video, we got video proof.
Yeah, I haven't seen it. All right. The speed 5, 1-inch melee.
Well, you know what I want even more than a character warjack?
I
want
the stone's going to go.
I want Kalissa too.
She's going to spend 1 for protective aura and stone strength. And it's going to advance into dick punching.
Question from the Twitch chat for Darrell. What do you think of the new protector colossal, the Revelator?
Yeah, buddy.
Yeah, buddy?
Yeah, buddy.
You're just waiting for it?
Yep.
Yeah, it's going to be really good. So it's really good. Just get it. Just get in line now and then buy it.
Well, yeah, guaranteed. I'm all about the buying it.
I mean, Judicator wasn't bad, though, right?
Judicator just suffered a bit in the changeover. It's not bad. It's just has other things it should be doing.
Yeah, and it just doesn't compete
with heavies. It's clearly outshone by the
Revelator. It doesn't compete with heavies right now, that's for sure.
No. He's just going to go here. Mm-hmm. I want you to go to there? No, I don't. I want you to go to here. That's too far. I'm cheating. Go there.
Filthy cheater.
All right. So, melee attacks. Time good to go. On him.
That's 12.
Or no, sorry. He's going to go and attack him.
Yep. I would rather get Kalissa 2 than Virus 3, but yeah. I'm
Death 12, Matt 6.
Kind of likely.
The Matt 6.
Yep. 7 hits. There might be Matt 5, and I'm a big cheater. Yeah, they're Matt 5, but 7 still hits. That's a 12.
Armor 19. How cool. Minus 2 from the Agonizer, so let's just say I'm effective armor 21.
Okay. Pal 11.
12 to kill.
Nope. This guy right here. Mm-hmm. 8 hits. Mm-hmm. Nope. And the last guy. Misses. Alright.
I want to get Ron too as a battle engine caster in Retribution. That'd be amazing. Like Ron, like driving an AFG or something like that.
Scaldi's gonna go.
Pretty sweet. Although Ron will probably still.
There's Scaldi's unit. He's gonna sack his move
Ron is
to
broken.
Stand. Okay. He's just gonna slide to here.
Shrine.
All right. So
the truffle shuffle.
Yeah. We're gonna start with Scaldi. He's going to attack that guy. Skaldi's Matt 7. Or sorry, Matt 8.
The Karax.
No, him.
Yeah, the Karax.
Hit.
Yep. Armor 19.
I am Pow. 12 Weapon Master.
8 to kill.
How about 11? Overtake. Still base to base. Attack him. So he has Rapid Strike.
Ferox.
Am I the back arc? Not quite. Oh, I am. So back arc. Nothing matters.
Matters a bit.
5 will hit you in the back arc, I assume.
Might 8.
Might 8. 13, 14, 15. Have 12 Weapon Master.
That's a 5. No, wait. You're probably in my bubble. Inches, you're in my bubble, so it dice off 7. So
okay,
I have 3 bosses left.
So Archimedes asked a question in the chat about saying he's a new protector player and wanted to kind of ask about some general
here
questions.
Sorry.
About
he'll attack him.
Protectorate. So one thing I would definitely advise you, Archimedes, is I mean, you just go back and look at some of our our video live streams with Protectorate. Darrow's played like a ton of different lists, even just since Mark 3 got launched. There's been some good stuff and some bad stuff. But you can at least see what he's been playing with and see what he thinks works a lot. He's been playing a lot of Resnik 1, Resnik 2.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Played a bit of Amon. Played Semi once or twice.
Defense 13.
Also, I mean, the forums are a great place to get list advice as well.
Not 7.
Yep.
So hit. Pop 12 Weaponmaster.
And even you can ask questions about Trollbloods. We'll try to, like, answer some questions.
Can I re-roll that?
It's hard for Darrell to ask questions on his turn, but, you know, that's how it goes.
I'm going to spend 1 on Calandra to re-roll that piece of shit. Mm-hmm.
But yeah, we put out somewhere around like 30 or 40 live stream videos of us just playing War Machine since MK3 dropped. There's a lot of Protector in there. There's lots of stuff that you can check out.
9 to the 5.
That should be the Spirit Gun.
Yep.
Here.
Also, if you're on Facebook, subscribe to the
5 to 12
Protector of Menoth Facebook private group. Just search for it on there. There's like a couple thousand people that are on there, and they post all the time and lots of good stuff.
Miss. Awesome, guys. Awesome.
Hey, Tomokazi. We do have one circle player in our meta. It's Todd. He also plays Retribution and Mercs, and he's kind of focusing on Retribution. But we do try and get him on to play some sort of on the stream once in a while. It's been a couple magic weeks ability. Since he's been out.
Magic ability 6 is hits a 15.
Mm-hmm.
All right, it's a POW something.
He's armor.
POW 12.
17.
POW 12. 5. You don't get your agonizer bonus against this.
Nope.
POW 12. POW 5. 2. Should I reroll a 7?
He has 10 boxes. So.
I'll leave it. Okay, so that's them. You should be in base, but whatever. Axer.
You don't have an Axer.
There's a Mauler in it. That did not work out as planned.
It isn't gone yet. Mauler. Lanyssa Bouncer. Yep.
And if he goes, he's not getting to the Despolier.
No, there's no way.
So, the Mauler will go. Not put arcane suppression up.
Yep.
So you're gonna go to here. Two to put rage on the bouncer. So rage is on the bouncer. He's angry, bugger.
Rage.
Rawr.
I see what's coming.
All right, and then I'm going to power attack two-handed, throw that biatch.
Yeah, you are.
On him.
That's 13.
That's 13?
Yep.
I'm at 6.
Sivon.
7 hits.
Just hits.
I have strength a lot more than you.
Probably. I'm strength.
I don't think you can possibly win
7.
It.
Strength 7. I'm 12 with 2 dice.
So.
You can't win.
No.
Nope.
Okay. And it's at him.
At him. He's
defense. Really, Zach?
13 as well.
Actually, sorry. Yeah, it's going to hit him. So straight line. All right, so it's straight melee damage on him, or is it strength on both?
It's strength on both. So strength, and that guy's
then
boosted.
Boosted. Okay.
On the one you threw, it's boosted.
Oh, it's not boosted on him, even though it's the same. Okay. So here, it's boosted.
Dice of 5.
POW 13.
It's actually additional.
Plus 1 strength from stone.
You could boost it.
Plus 1 strength from stone.
Nice. What's your power strength?
Well, that's still
13. That will kill. Okay. And then on him, it's 2 dice. From strength 13.
Dice off
5. So yeah,
stone. Dice off 4.
Off 4?
Yep. There's 17?
Yep.
Wow.
1 point.
Hold on.
that's actually okay. Lanyssa.
It would have been nice for him to be dead.
Yeah, it would be. But I can't boost that damage roll.
So. I know.
Lanyssa.
And he's knocked down as well.
Yep.
They have steady.
Oh, okay, never mind.
Lanyssa. What are you going to do there, Chickapoo? I can see Mulg and I'm in his back arc. I'm going to ice bolt him.
Seems right.
Match ability 7, I think. Yep.
Yeah. So he's like an 8 in the back.
Anything but.
Oh no! I'd just say that! If only had a caster. Oh, it's from the faction, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's too bad.
Fuck balls.
Damn, that sucks.
Does he have any rules I can abuse right now?
Nope.
Judge, my opponent didn't give me his War Beast card when I took over it.
It's over here, Phil, and it should tell it.
Card do it in the face.
Fuddle. Range 10.
So as far as starting Circle out as a new player, I can't give a ton of advice because I don't play Circle. I can tell you that Baldur 2 is very strong and he's a very forgiving caster to play. The worm tokens thing is a bit off-putting for new players sometimes when you're damaging your own caster all the time.
Calandra's gonna go.
If you play with Megalith, he'll be also healing every turn, so it offsets that quite a bit. And you can also heal yourself just using Fury. And if you don't want to take worm tokens, you can use your action to just remove them as well. So that's one thing. But Baldur 2 just basically he plays armor stacking kind of, and you just you take a tank.
What's his armor?
And
18.
And it's pretty it's a pretty
for two
competitive list right now.
I'm gonna cast Befuddle. What's his defense?
11.
So I need a 3. Hit
for Archimedes.
So Red Thing
isn't
3.
Necessarily like a go-to caster in Protectorate for a lot of people. It's just like it's definitely Daryl's favorite. So that's why he plays a lot of Resnik 1 and 2. Resnik is definitely strong. He's good. Resnik 2 has a lot of play. Durst is really good, especially against gunlines, which are really popular right now. Semi 2 is really strong. He can run jacks that just never die
because of the miraculous
vision. There's a lot of good stuff in Protectorate. Hyrule is super strong right now. Just being able to bring back all the things.
What range shit do you have?
Range
attacks.
Super strong.
Okay.
And magic nukes.
Yeah. All right. Next, the Axers, or the Bouncer, is going to go.
Bouncer.
He's going to advance to within half an inch of him.
Range.
Okay. And I will attack with the ball and chain.
It's a ball and chain.
It's pow 16. So off 2 is 14.
Nice off 4.
So I need to add a hit first. Mm-hmm. I hit. Off 4.
Yep.
I'll take that. 8 to the 4.
8 to the
4.
Damn!
Okay. Second initial with my shitty shield. What's the range on that? Half. I did not position him properly, but that's okay.
Did you befuddle the spell?
Yeah, okay. And turn around. So, shield attack. Hits. I'm minus 2.
Mm-hmm.
Plus 4, so plus 2 is a 13.
They fall off. 5.
5 to the 1.
Wow.
Dice.
This happened. Blind attack.
Not for me.
Well, you're under Starcross, remember, for everything, right?
Yeah.
Hit.
That hits.
That's a 4.
So this is, out 14. Out 4.
No.
You roll that shit. Same. 5, 6. Blind attack. Hit. This is with the ball and chain.
Mm-hmm. 4 to 4. Question from Chad is, have we run Tristan Durant as full caster yet? Daryl's tried about once or twice.
Just once.
Tristan, just once. Tristan 2. Yeah. He thought he was okay. But he wasn't pretty. He wasn't blown away with him. He just really likes the casters he's playing. So he's not good enough to get into yeah. Darrell's competitive pairing. That's all.
He's fine.
Yeah, he's okay. He's not bad.
Nothing.
We have a troll in the chat. No shoes says, in our opinion, how do you think Stormlights should be buffed?
Oh, I'm going to let this drop. These guys can do their...
They should be buffed by gaining the Lance vengeance. Rule. It's a really great rule.
Yeah, they should totally have
they
the Lance
should
rule.
Gain the Lance rule. That'd be awesome for them.
There's a bow like that.
Just a second.
What's his armor before...
Kassem gets another point.
Yep. Oh, nice.
His armor?
Yeah.
21.
Kassem's on 2 control points. Oh, no.
Don't bother him. These guys, he'll swing at him. Not 7. We'll hit with a 9. Yeah. Or with an 8.
Yep.
How 10.
Or 15.
But we'll tough check. Oh. This guy onto him. A 4 on a 7's an 11. Oops. Miss.
We also have a clock situation happening now as well, because Kassem is on about 6.5 minutes.
Catapult.
And Darrell's on over 12 minutes.
I think you have Valor, so...
So Kassem is going to have to get his shit in gear if he's going to win this.
Not snake eyes, so it hits.
Fast enough. Although he will likely 20. Be going to 3 points.
He will go to 3 points.
On his turn. And maybe more if he can
get
an
objective.
It's going to
be 11 points.
If Darrell can jam out the
this one,
scenario
seven,
after
five.
That,
whoa. It's
going to be tough for Kassem to come back.
So 7 points. hits, not snake eyes. And dice. Is going to be 10 more points, so the objective's gone.
It's armor 20. Are you taking off?
Yep, it's POW 20.
Okay.
Burst
from
fire.
What?
Burst fire. So it's plus 2 on large bases, plus 1 on medium bases.
Okay.
Then the last damage on your stone is 5 of 13, so nothing. Okay. Mauler is not going to do anything, I don't think.
Nice yeah. damage. Yep. Those things are POW 18 base?
Yep.
What?
Yep.
Are you sure?
Inaccurate.
18 base?
Yeah. No, take 4 damage off it.
Yeah, so not
yeah,
bad.
No, there's 16 base.
So
yeah.
8 damage. Shot it twice.
So the first one was, we said 7, so that goes down to a 5. And then
yeah,
the other
so
one, we said 10,
left.
Goes down to an 8, so it has 2 boxes left.
Yeah, that makes more sense.
Yeah.
Still, that's good enough for me.
Because the stone affects
it. Dirty, stinking cheater.
So it's got 2 boxes left.
Well, I get 2 for dominating the flag, right?
And if all the minis are happy to help, we want to get more people into the hobby. Because the best thing Warmachine is playing against other people. I have played against Warmachine against myself before, and it was not nearly as interesting.
Since, whatever, I forgot to do Reeve, so my Razorworm fails. Despolier. With 3, he has a threshold of 10. So he's good. Agonizer. Not good. So he frenzies.
Just Reeve, it's fine.
Well, I'd still run into a fury problem there.
Yeah, but
maybe
leave and then do your check.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This guy still fails.
Okay. Like, we're not in a tournament here. So like...
Except he has 4 minutes left on his clock.
So, I think it still boosted the hit, right? But not
yeah.
boosted damage. So, look, he hits your guy with a 7, 13 total, so he misses him.
Oh, man. Oh, jeez. Wow, boosting hit and missing is just really, really tilting for me. I know. Kassem's actually handling it pretty well.
Well,
he's rolling average, except for the Starcross is fucking him.
Oh, yeah,
I'm rolling average, but the average is like
he's
six,
rolling.
Two,
he's
two.
Rolling like 6-2, but then the next dice is like a
yeah.
1,
yeah,
so it's
yeah,
fucking
yeah.
him. Like
it's
he's
bad.
He's rolling totally fine. It's
this
just
guy's just gonna. Wait, does Rhadeim have pounce?
Does he have tarot?
Well, jump is.
Oh, you're leaping. Okay.
Does he have? Yes, he has pounce. So pounces at your objective.
Yes.
Pounces!
Auto hits, POW 12. Dice off 8. It gets rid of the objective.
Okay.
Then he'll do his armor pierce on your mauler, because why not?
This is good.
Misses.
Roll 3 dice hit, yeah.
Unless he's defense 11.
No, he's not.
So that puts me to 3. Dominate takes me to 5. So, just for fun.
These flags are dominate for 1.
They're dominate for 1?
Yeah.
Are they?
Yeah.
Lame! So, basically I have to get hex.
We didn't play
yeah,
our...
dominate 1.
Yeah, we didn't play our scenario tile at the beginning of the game. That's why I didn't
so
tell you
I can
you
run 12 inches. So,
yeah, if you can run that flag,
5
you
to here. And then, the question is, yeah, I can get to there. Because that's 3 inches, so 6 inches. I have 12
total. What's your speed? Your speed 6?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can probably
I'm just outside of 4.
Just outside of 4. So, let's just...
If it's 5 to the rough, then you definitely have enough
to
get there.
To so, we'll run to here.
Yep.
Holy shit.
And...
So you got the objective?
Got the objective. I guess Mulk can just stand dominate that one.
Control.
Yeah. And
cast some wings because I rolled snake eyes.
Basically, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's the game.
Well, these guys could have walked up and controlled it.
You already have
I wouldn't have gotten the control.
Anyway, that's the game. Kassem wins on scenario. 5 points. So
yep.
And basically, it did come down basically to Lanyssa. Because
I rolled snake eyes on Lanyssa. And I missed one attack here that I needed to overtake to get into him.
Yeah. That would have been pretty sweet. Scorne victory. So apparently they're not unplayable trash.
No. They just always have to play for scenario.
Yeah. Nothing wrong with that, I guess.
I should have really put Death March on the Ferox first. I thought boosted attacks on a charge would have been fine.
So sorry, what was someone asked me a question when it was my turn?
Oh, I don't remember.
Yeah.
There was a guy that was asking about just like noob advice for Protectorate. I told him to look at some of her old battle reports see what you were playing around with at the beginning. Market.
Play what you like to look up.
Yeah. And also just like join the Facebook groups because there's a ton of good advice in there.
Oh yeah. If you're on the forums, don't listen to anything Soulblader says. He's the forum troll.
Yeah. Anyway, so list discussion. So Darrell, what do you think of your Calandra list swapping out the High Moon for the champs?
I like it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you like the champs better than High Moon?
In the last game I played, champs would have been better.
Okay.
In this game, Highwaymen would have been better.
Yep.
So,
yeah, that's the way it goes.
I think overall, though, the champs are good. I got a lot of work out of them. It's just I was using rerolls and things like that. Everything's going well.
Yep.
I missed the key attacks I needed to hit. So, I needed to hit a key attack over here.
Yeah.
Had I hit it, I would have been able to get a champ on Mulg.
Okay.
So I missed that one, which I could have rerolled, but I rerolled stuff earlier in the turn. I didn't save it for the key activation,
sure,
so that's my mistake.
Yeah, that's a problem.
Right? Really, correct me if I'm wrong, I feel this was my game to lose.
Sure.
And I did, because I'm good at it. I feel like my matchup
you
was
the matchup.
I had the matchup.
Yeah. No, I don't disagree with that.
So it was my game to lose, and I did, because I didn't save my Fate Blast for the right activation.
Do you think committing Mulg when you did was a mistake?
I feel that I was going to lose Mulg anyway.
Okay.
Mulg or the Mauler.
Yeah.
Because of how things were deployed, the Mauler was behind, so Mulg is the one that's going to go.
Yeah.
I don't mind trading Mulg for a key heavy.
Sure.
I feel that the Despolier is more key to the Kassem's plans most of the time, so I would have preferred that one.
Yeah.
But because I missed the attacks on the Ferox in the middle, I couldn't get Lanyssa out to Hunter's Mark.
Yeah.
And I also did an order of activations mistake. So instead of putting Rush on Mulg with Calandra, I did a bunch of other shit and moved on.
Yeah.
Right? So, again, my mistake
there.
You
were able to do it anyway because Lanyssa did hit.
Yes.
Which is nice.
Yeah.
But,
I like the list. That was a mistake there
Would
with
you
the champions.
Battle group at all?
I like this battle group.
I think it's a great battle group too. Like just like
this is like the troll standard.
Totally, yeah. Like Mauler, Mulg, Bouncer, Axer is such a good package.
Yeah.
It just does a bit of everything. It's really nice.
And like my Doomy 2 battle group is this plus Rock.
Yeah.
So like I think Mauler, Mulg, Axer, Bouncer is like the perfect troll battle group.
Okay.
In my opinion.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
So I like that battle group. Stone is always the stone, Runebearer is always the Runebearer. Like
it's all good.
I didn't get as much work out of the Chronicler as I wanted to this game.
One thing I wanted to ask you about, that we actually took a bit of flack, that people on our troll faction review commented that we didn't take into account the Soulslave ability on the Runebearer enough. And they're saying that you should be...
It's amazing.
They're saying you should be using it for stuff like, you know, Runebearer putting out a befuddle that you can re-roll to hit.
Yes.
Like, it's really strong. And but you had him playing in the back the whole game. Like, do you think maybe you should have been playing him up further?
He was in the back because of my condensed deployment issue.
Okay.
With the water.
Sure.
If I had thought a little bit more,
yeah,
maybe that side would have been better for me because it's more open.
Okay.
However, yes, you can get three befuddles out of Calandra.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
With the Runebearer.
Yeah.
So it's very powerful on the Alpha Strike.
Well, and I just like the idea of being able to put him up front, kind of, get a befuddle out, and you get a reroll, so it's, like, super accurate.
Yeah.
And you're not risking Calandra.
No, there's a lot of things that the Runebearer can do now with being able to cast that spell three or less.
Yeah.
Extremely powerful ability.
Sure, yeah.
Yes, they were right. Like, it's... You don't play them back like you used to anymore.
Yeah.
In this case, I did, but it was because of a deployment issue, not because of a playman issue or a playing issue. In the tournament, I used it a lot.
Okay.
I used it for... I was going to use it in the Virus 1 matchup, but I got stomped pretty quickly. What is it here? And on Doomshaper 2, I was using it as well. Because Doomy, when he's got the 7 Fury, he's okay. You don't need it as much.
Yeah.
But I was using it for, like, you can Hex Blast with it.
Oh, that's really good.
Like, that's just amazing.
Another upkeep removal is really strong,
What is it? Hex Blast is the main one with him.
Okay, cool. Yeah, or all the only one, so I should say. Moving to Skorne, Kassem, what do you think of your Hexy list? I mean, so you're kind of just going through the casters and playing them to see how they feel. But, like, so what did you think of the list you came up with for Hexy, and was it decent?
It was okay.
Is there any particular synergy with the catapults with Hexy? Like, why do you have that catapult in the list?
It's just more of, you know, on feet turn, you arc some shots into their support.
Oh, okay. And they can just, like, kill all kinds of stuff. Yeah, yeah. Okay.
That's the theory. I mean, like, two Powie team shots against objectives are nice, too.
It's not bad.
And...
Unless you're cheating.
Way better. Not quite as good as the Pat 20 shot, but still pretty good.
We caught it. It's enough to adjust the math.
Yeah. Cool. So anything you would change on the list? Would you change your battle group at all?
Well, I mean, Despolier's there for free upkeep, so I would prefer him dying over the Gladiator. They both actually hit the same with Dark Shroud there.
That's true,
so.
Yeah.
Yeah, I hate Dark Shroud.
But...
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Why don't you play Crix? Dirty cheater.
I mean, like,
you
know,
I had some dice issues. Right?
I did have some,
like,
dice
when you were
issues.
Boosting to hit with your Razorworm and missing champs. Like,
yeah, that's
well,
probably
those Ferox were all boosted hits because cavalry charges.
And half of them missed. Yeah,
no, they all missed.
They all missed.
They all missed.
It was so ridiculous. Just
what do you think?
The dice there.
You think Starcross had an impact?
Yeah,
it's like even on average, I'd be rolling eights instead of tens.
I know, right?
And I was missing.
Yeah, no, it was brutal. Very brutal. Cool.
That's the only I should have put Death March on them.
Sure.
That would have fixed that.
Karax would have. I was still rolling bad. I was, like, rolling fives on three dice.
Well, you were able to pull it out, and I think Darrell's right that it was a bad matchup for you. So, I mean, hey, the score must be terrible, right?
Yeah, it must be.
How does it feel, though? Losing against an unplayable faction.
It's
fine. Good times.
Instead, it came down, like, I was fine to give you the one control point, but I'm like, I have a few options I can toss a zap in, and the chain of options I had to kill Mulg, they all failed. So.
Yep. There's a question in the chat about retribution in all field. It's what do I recommend for list building for playing who's the boss with retribution? For me, like, I always want to take a melee jack, a ranged jack, a melee unit, and a ranged unit because you never know what caster you're gonna get. So you want to have a bit of everything, and you also probably want like some good solos and stuff as well. Just because, like, you know, if you get a caster with the right ranged buffs, your ranged unit's gonna be awesome. Get a caster with the right melee buffs, your melee is going to be awesome. And so I like to take a really, really balanced list when I play Who's the Boss, because you want to be able to benefit from whatever caster you get has. I mean, you could go balls the walls and take all battle group and hope you get synergy, right? But that's just, like, a really low odds, right? So
yeah.
I like to go balanced. That's how I build for Who's the Boss.
My strategy was the best.
Who's the Boss? Well, you're talking about spell draft. Right?
No. Remember that one Who's the Boss played at Game Chamber?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Just take errata'ed Sentinels. And then just randomly get ball busting range casters every night.
Yeah, it's a good feat.
I mark two sentinels.
Yeah, mark two sentinels, the ones that are good.
I had a raider in my list, two sentinels, incendiary, and who cares what else I had.
Yeah, doesn't matter.
Butcher one, Ozian, and who's that legion caster?
Veil two.
Veil two, yeah.
Some good stuff.
Anyway. You had to fucking play when you had Ossian. That was bullshit.
Who's the Boss is a fun format. I like
it. It's fun.
It's annoying to have like every single caster in the game, but it's still fun.
I think Hordes is more advantaged in that format because you can choose some of your spells.
Yeah, having access to Animi is actually quite powerful, yeah. Okay, well, we're going to just take a break for a couple minutes, but we'll be back with another game in about 10 minutes. So sit tight. We will be back very soon.